Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video I want to talk about change fatigue or change exhaustion. And typically when we talk about this, it's related around the workplace and what leaders are doing to move the business forward, and there's just a lot coming at you. In this case, I want to relate it to Microsoft Fabric because I think there are a lot of things around it that are similar. Before we get into that, if you like this video, be sure to hit that like button, smash it if you so desire. And if you want to see more videos from both Patrick and myself, hit that subscribe button to stay up to date. All right, when we think of change exhaustion, this really refers to like the adverse effect of ever-changing workplace, or in this case, an ever-changing technology or Microsoft Fabric. And this leads to a lot of things that can just be emotional, right? So are you getting aggressive towards those things, or your anxiety jumping up? These are all things that come up because of this item or because of change fatigue, right? There's just too many things coming at you. Over on Harvard Business Review, I found an article where they talk about just navigating uncertainty requires that we push back against our natural impulse to run from discomfort. When faced with anxiety, we tend to immediately jump into action mode. And I think this is true. Something's changing. We got to do something. There's that new monthly blog for Microsoft Fabric or Power BI, and we got to go implement some of those changes into our project. And that's a reality. We need to realize and recognize that that's happening. And maybe, you know, we don't necessarily need to step into action right away. Over out on Forbes.com, John Cotter wrote that change fatigue is marked by passive resistance or even aggression, exhaustion, complacency, and disengagement towards change. And this environment is likely contributing to staggering statistics around burnout. In that case, it was relating again to workplace and your actual employee burnout in terms of how managers can deal with that. But again, I think this is related to any technology where it's updating at a very high rate. We went through this in the beginning of Power BI when every month there was just a deluge of a bunch of updates coming at us. That still happens on the Power BI side, but now it's even more so on Microsoft Fabric. And there's so many more things with inside of Microsoft Fabric that we've got to account for as part of that. So recognizing that, I want to leave you with four things to think about. First, when you're hitting these things or you're getting the monthly updates or you're figuring that I got to do all the things, pause, take a break, step back. Think about how it relates to you. Think about how it relates to the business. Do we have to go do something? It's okay if we don't. What you're working on is probably good enough, right? It's probably going to move the business forward. You've probably already got some plan in place of how you're going to work on your given project. Do you need to disrupt that just because something new came out or there's a new update? The answer may be yes, and we've got to go take action, but take the time to contemplate and think about it before you go into that action mode. Number two, we need to balance innovation with moving the business forward. That's the main goal. You're working for a company, right? You're working on a project and, you know, we've got leaders that are looking for us to get something done so that we can, you know, meet business objectives. And so that's your primary focus. And if you did pause and you relook at what you're doing, do those items that you've just read about incorporate into what you're doing, and can you leverage those? If you can, great. If they can't, cool. Just put it on the back shelf in your brain and maybe come back to it at a later point and just focus on what your plan already was. The plan was a plan for a reason, and we want to focus on that plan. Number three, don't just go for the new shiny. I've seen it so many times. We get something out there and we're like, oh, we got to do this right now. Notebooks are there now. So, oh, I got to do all my automation and orchestration through the notebook. Well, how were you doing that before? And maybe that's okay, and you don't need to change it for the sake of changing it. The items that you're already using are good enough. They're working. We don't necessarily need to just disrupt all of that because of the new shiny. There's a fear of missing out, like, oh my gosh, all these people are already using this. I'm gonna fall behind. That's okay. You've got time. There's going to be other projects and other ways you can do that, which leads me into my fourth item for you, which is phase it in. Does it have to all go in today? And people ask me like, oh, I need to lift and shift everything into Microsoft Fabric. Do you? This is one of the beautiful things I love about Microsoft Fabric. We could start small and maybe we just start leveraging one link. Maybe your project that you've got, it's a big project, data warehouse project. Let's start with the data first, right? Where is that data stored? And maybe you're outputting that into Azure Data Lake storage or out in Amazon S3 bucket somewhere. And maybe the first thing we do is we say, look, we're just going to adopt OneLake as the central store of this data. And so we just repoint from our ADLS Gen 2 storage to OneLake. That's the first bit. Nothing else changes. Everything else is still in play. Now we look at the next piece. Well, we've got notebooks somewhere else. Well, maybe we start moving those notebooks into Microsoft Fabric and we orchestrate it there. So it doesn't have to be everything today. we can take it piece by piece. Think about it like Legos, right? We're just stacking the Legos slowly as we go. And as we build that up, we start learning about that technology, learning about the pieces along the way and what works and what doesn't. I just wanted to get this out there, just let you know, you're not alone. It's okay. We're all in this together. We're all trying to learn it together. Everything's new. There is a flood of information. And I thank you for being patient and working through that. GynaCube is a place too where you can come and just vent about that, right? There is a lot. And it's exciting, but it's also stressful. And I recognize that. All right. Let me know down in the comments below if you have had thoughts about this, if you're struggling with it. What are you doing to handle that and to make sure that it's not overwhelming and you just don't burn out? Over my head, you're going to see another video just related around Microsoft Fabric or Power BI that we put out. So go check that out. It might be useful to you. As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.